Hallo iedereen, welkom bij Dutch and Go. Today we're going to talk about negation and specifically the word geen. I know that negation is an issue for you, but in the next couple of videos I'll be talking about how to use negation and how to use it correctly, and all the while also giving you some examples that will make it very easy for you to understand and that you can use in many, many normal and day-to-day situations. Let's go! So, as I'm sure you know, there are two ways of negating a sentence in Dutch. So you could either use the word geen or you could use the word niet. In this video, I'll be focusing mostly on when to use the word geen. And in another video, I'll be talking about how to use niet and how to position niet correctly in the sentence as well. Okay? But for now, let's focus on geen and when to use it. So first of all, we use it for uncountable words in the singular form. Remember, a video that I also made as well was about uncountable words, indefinite words, which you can check out. And geen would be here as well in this case with uncountable words. So things like chocolade, geld, zin, etc. Things that cannot be quantified. So let's look at some examples, okay? Where the main substantive is singular and uncountable. Ik drink melk. Ik drink geen melk. Ik eet chocolade. Ik eet geen chocolade. Dit is plastiek. Dat is geen plastiek. Een kat eet vlees. Een koe eet geen vlees. Ik spreek Nederlands, maar ik spreek geen Koreaans. Vanavond hebben we les. In het weekend hebben we geen les. Heb je zin? Nee, ik heb geen zin. Ik ben moe. Ik drink alcohol. Moslims drinken meestal geen alcohol. Ik heb vanavond tijd, maar ik heb op dit moment geen tijd. Hij heeft geld, zij heeft geen geld. Het is mooi weer, het is geen mooi weer. So these were the group of uncountable substantives, things like weather, money, time, all of those things, material, food which needs to be quantified before it can be used, for example, gram chocolade instead of chocolade, etc. Then you could quantify it, okay? But all of these nouns are unquantifiable. Let's look at the second category now. So then the second category are the countable words, which also are indefinite, okay? And they could sometimes be used also in plural when it's a general statement, when combined with he, but in general my idea or my tip here for you would be to just follow English and you'll get there either way. So for example, let's look at some specific cases in singular. Ik heb een broer, okay, but if I wanted to negate that, I would probably use the plural because I wanted to negate that I don't have brothers or sisters for that matter. Dus ik heb een broer. Ik heb geen broers of zussen. Mijn zus heeft een dochter. Ik heb geen kinderen. Mijn vriendin heeft een kat. Ik heb geen huisdieren. Ik koop een nieuwe auto. Mijn vader koopt geen nieuwe auto. We hebben een tuin. Zij hebben geen tuin. Ze wonen in een appartement. Ik vind dat een goede film. Zij vindt dat geen goede film. Or, for example, the plural, indefinite substantives. Mijn broer rookt sigaretten. Ik rook geen sigaretten, maar sigaren. Wij hebben enkele problemen. Zij hebben geen problemen. Mijn moeder heeft 3 planten. Ik heb geen planten. Nederland heeft mooie steden. De Noordpool heeft geen mooie steden. So there you are. These were some examples. I hope that they were helpful for you. So with regards to using geen, the only criteria is just that the substantive has to be indefinite. Okay, it has to be an indefinite substantive. So you can recognize them either because they have een when they're singular, okay, or nothing in front of them. Nothing when they're uncountable or plural. Okay? That's it. So basically, geen we use for all indefinite substantives. In all of the other cases, when we don't have that indefinite substantive, it's niet. And that I will be explaining to you in my next video. So, this was my videos for today about geen, the negating the sentence with geen. Thank you so much for watching. Please check out as well the blog post down below because, you know, I'm always posting new content. And in the article below, you'll also find more examples and also some cool exercises of how you can train this at home as well. Give a like if you like. Please subscribe and tot de volgende keer.